Today we have a Dr. Anupama with us. Today we are going to discuss about how does IVF lab matters in terms of the IVF pregnancy rates. Dr. Anupama, one thing we want to know, and in our viewers also, everybody want to know about how does IVF lab matters in terms of IVF pregnancy rates?
Yes, I think every IVF lab, a person who works in an IVF unit, and even the doctors know that the heart of any IVF success rate also lays in the lab and in the clinics. Now that we are in the lab of Mamata Fertility Hospital, let's talk about the lab, how this can improve a patient's chance to get pregnant. Because at the end, all these patients who come, they want to get pregnant.
So what kind of incubator is suitable in the IVF laboratory?
You should understand that there are three different kind of incubators. Very simple.
Does the embryo freezing really helps
to
the patients?
Yes. So you have to compare embryo freezing now to the past.
Namaste everyone, myself Madhusudan Rao, working as an embryologist at Mamata Fertility Hospital, Secunderabad. Today we have a Dr. Anupama with us. She is a gynecologist as well as she is an embryologist working with us, and also she is a lead embryologist working in Kiel University, Germany. Today we are going to discuss about how does IVF lab matters in terms of the IVF pregnancy rates. Let's start. Hello Dr. Anupama.
Yes.
Thank you for being with us.
Thank you.
Dr. Anupama, one thing we want to know, and in our viewers also, everybody want to know about how does IVF lab matters in terms of IVF pregnancy rates?
Yes. I think every IVF lab, a person who works in an IVF unit, and even the doctors know that the heart of any IVF success rate also lays in the lab and in the clinics. Now that we are in the lab of Mamata Fertility Hospital, let's talk about the lab, how this can improve a patient's chance to get pregnant. Because at the end, all these patients who come, they want to get pregnant. So can you guess what's the first thing? Or you're an embryologist, you know.
Yeah, I think in the lab, IVF laboratory, the air quality is plays a major role.
Yes.
I think so.
Absolutely, yes. If you go to a really internationally standardized lab, you will see that they have HEPA filters to decrease the particle count inside the lab. And they even have something called VOC filters to decrease something called volatile organic compounds in the lab. Now, why is it that we are so bothered about clean air in the lab? Every time you have to think about the embryo actually is growing inside the uterus of the woman. That means when this embryo is taken out, we have to give it the same kind of protection that the uterus of the woman is giving. And that is why first the air quality plays a role. If the particle count is high, or if the lab is next to an area with high pollution and they're not able to protect the lab from this kind of pollution, or many people are entering the lab, automatically you'll see particle count increase, and the embryos of patients, they look really bad, and these patients won't get pregnant. So I would say yes. Do you have anything else to say?
Yeah, of course. The air filtrations we talked about, and the incubators.
Yes.
So what kind of incubators suitable in the IVF laboratory?
Yes.
Because people are being practicing from last 30 to 40 years. So what are the changes happened, and how the MFH, Mamata Fertility Hospital, get hold of the new technology? How?
Okay. So this is a very important question. You should understand that there are three different kind of incubators. Very simple. Anyone can, as soon as they look at the incubator, they'll understand what it is. A conventional incubator is large. A benchtop incubator is small on top of a bench. So it's called benchtop. And the third incubator is a benchtop with a camera. In a conventional incubator, you can put many patients' embryos at the same time. But every time you open it to check the embryos, all the patients get affected. In a benchtop, each chamber has one patient. So first, each patient has their identity in a special chamber. And second, when I check, for example, Swati's embryos, I am not disturbing Sushila's embryos next to it. So the embryos are protected again, just like the uterus of a woman. Because in one uterus, there's only one embryo usually growing. And, you know, you don't open the uterus to check the embryo every time. So because of this protected environment of a benchtop incubator, the embryos grow better, they are healthier, they reach the correct state at the correct time, and the pregnancy chances increase. Now, when the camera comes in and you can take a video of how these embryos are actually growing, you can choose which one. You have the experience also. What is your favorite part about taking the video of the embryo while it is growing?
It is helpful to the patient, those who are already failed cases, and we'll see the embryo's growth.
Yes.
And how the embryos are cleaving at particular time.
Yes.
And at what time it reached to the
correct level. Exactly. So we can choose out of the many eggs the patient gets, which embryo is the best embryo to transfer. And usually within the first transfer, they get pregnant without going through that heartache of repeated failures.
Yes.
And what else do you think affects the embryo growth or success rate?
And disposables, especially. Yes. And my mentor always says that, you know, quality products never be cheap.
Yeah. So true. Quality products are never cheap.
So in our laboratory, we dedicated to the, you know, particular slot of the cost for the disposables.
Yes.
So these quality products, you know, like of course in the IVF industry, most of the products came from the Europe.
Yes.
Or maybe USA. So we get it from the very good certified products,
yes,
that is the FDA and CE mark products.
Yes.
And also we use that products in a proper way.
Yes.
So
I completely agree with you, because just so that, you know, I'll give a little information so that people who are watching understand why is it that we need quality products. The eggs, the sperm, the embryos, when they are growing, it makes a big difference what they are exposed to. So they are exposed to the dish in which they grow, or the pipettes that we are using to process it. All the plastic that is used, if it is poor quality and not checked before, again, the embryo quality will be poor and these patients will not get pregnant. So unless you use high quality, like you said, expensive products, the embryos are not going to grow well. And it is our duty as embryologists to give the best possible quality to our patients so that they get pregnant faster. For example, this is a dish that we use to grow embryos. And you can see clearly here, it says that it has been checked by something called MEA, that is mouse embryo assay, because we know in embryology that a mouse embryo is stronger than a human embryo. And so what they do is the entire plastic is checked with mouse embryos, that embryos are reaching the correct stage. We know that that brand of plastic is good to be used, and only then we use it. I mean, we talk about microplastics now in environment, in the water, affecting us such big humans with so many cells, whereas the egg is only one cell. And we have to treat it with the respect and the responsibility to give it the best possible environment to have the best embryo to increase IVF success chances.
The patient selection also, it really matters.
Yes.
For getting a good pregnancy outcome.
I'm so happy you said this, because this is where I feel the society should understand that every patient is not the same. For example, you and me, we look so different, but inside we all are human. Yes?
Correct.
So you might need a different kind of treatment. I might need a different kind of treatment. So individualized care, that is for each patient, what exactly needs to be followed in the lab is also different. And that's why at Mamata Fertility Hospital, and also in Germany, in the university where I'm the head of the lab, we make sure to check each patient's history, their present condition, and plan their journey in the lab, how the sperm should be processed, how the egg should be treated, how the embryo should grow, which medium would be better, how the transfer should be done. We individualize it to improve our success chances.
Is there any other equipment we needed other than the incubators to how you people are making the quality control management?
Yes. So I'm happy you spoke about quality control, because this is one of the most important things of increasing pregnancy chances of patients through the IVF lab. The temperature matters, the pH of the media matters, the osmolality matters, what kind of media you use matters. Obviously, over here, God is so great that in the human body, the temperature of the uterus, the pH of the area around it, all of it, the body just automatically checks. But here in the lab, we do hourly checks, daily checks, monthly checks, that everything is running stable, that the conditions remain. The minute the temperature increases by more than 1.5 degrees or decreases more than 1.5, that embryo is going to arrest. It's not going to grow. So we have to be, and like that, there are many factors that need to be checked. And I'm very proud to say that at Mamata Fertility Hospital, I see you doing it. We do it together, that we maintain our culture. And obviously, I have to also say, in Germany, we have our checks. Madhu, it was lovely speaking with you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Anupama. I have one more question.
Yes.
For you. Does the embryo freezing really helps to the patients?
Yes. So you have to compare embryo freezing now to the past. Around 10 to 15 years ago, once an embryo was frozen, the chance that after thawing it would survive was less than 70%. But with the freezing protocols today, I am proud to say that our center definitely has a survival of 99%. That is, if a patient's embryo is frozen, the chance that that embryo will survive after thaw is 99%, in fact, almost 100%. Now, why is this helpful? Because medically, the endometrium can be prepared for that embryo to implant. So we take this opportunity to freeze the embryo and then thaw it when the patient is healthy, her endometrium is good for implantation, that her chances of pregnancy are higher. So yes, I'm a big supporter of frozen embryo transfer in individualized cases, but the cryo unit of the center should be good. They should be checking their liquid nitrogen levels. The cryo unit should be so robust that they are able to support in increases chances of pregnancy.
Again, it is a cost matter, right?
Yes.
Like the cryo tanks. There are certain cryo tanks are very cheap.
Yes.
We don't know when we will fail.
Yes.
And there are certain cryo tanks are very expensive.
Yes. So again, it is better to go in for the higher quality, because we are talking about our children, our generations to come. Patients put in so much of money, effort, time, their emotion. So we believe in giving the best quality to these patients that they attain this pregnancy as quickly as possible.
And one more thing. There are certain add-on services people are offering, and we are also offering to our patients.
Yes.
So how it will help to the patients?
Yes. So again, this is individualized basis. There are some patients, they are young, they oocyte quality is good, sperm quality is good, they don't need add-ons. So they are not the type of patients who need this. But yes, there are patients, multiple IVF failures, they've gotten pregnant, but they keep losing the pregnancy. We know that there is an internal sperm problem in these patients. So checking something like the DNA fragmentation of the sperm, doing a PICSI, doing microfluidics to choose the best sperm, or using embryo glue, doing a genetic analysis of the embryo, PGTA, or many such add-ons on an individualized basis definitely help the patient.
And we have seen that, you know, you brought us this LIT.
Yes.
Leukocyte infusion therapy.
Yes.
It is helping us, you know, like so many patients got conceived.
Yes.
And again they continued their pregnancies.
Yes. I just saw the data, and our live birth rate is definitely 20% higher than what would have been expected. And again, I would definitely insist, this is not for all patients. This is only for the select few of patients where we have ruled out everything else. But yes, I am with you. Add-ons help in individualized patient care.
And again, PRP also, platelet
yes.
rich plasma.
Yes. So you can say that it is not yet evidence-based, but again, these are patients who are looking for really improving their chances of pregnancy. And so, yes, we need to give them that chance.
Thank you so much, Dr. Anupama, for giving us valuable inputs about the IVF lab quality. How does it matter?
Thank you so much, Madhu. I really hope that with this, everyone who's listening understands how the quality of the IVF lab plays such a big role in getting the best quality embryo and increasing the chances of an IVF cycle in which the patient puts in so much of their time and energy. I wish them all the best. And even I wish that we host more such things together to, you know, get out the knowledge that people understand how important it is that the quality of an IVF lab is maintained.
Thank you so much, viewers, for watching this video, and see you in the next video.